I'm my Gemini and Gemini rising friend, Sandra from 4YourChi.com, here today to do your tarot and oracle monthly reading for December 2021. Thanks for being here with me. Let's get to your reading. As we start off December, the Gemini's energy is feeling kind of low here with the base chakra. You're just sort of going through the motions. You're not really having a lot of fun. You could be feeling slightly under the weather, and that's because the base chakra needs to be addressed. It needs to be cleared out. The best way to do that is to do yoga if you can. Yoga clears out all the chakras, or you can go on YouTube, do a base chakra or all the chakra clearing meditation for that matter. It can't hurt. Sea salt bath is another way, a quick way to get that resolved. What's the advice card? The Arts. So there's definitely a message of bringing your creativity to lift your physical energy at this time. Do what you love to do. If you guys love to do artwork or music, write, you know, whatever it is, it's advised to do that to get you out of a funk if you feel like you're in a funk at the beginning of December. Your money, the crown chakra. The crown chakra says that you're getting information from your higher self about your money and what to do here. Now, this is going to be different for every one of you. If you're a Gemini who's getting a message that you need to cut back on spending and budget, then that's what it is. You know, if you're getting ideas on how to create more money, side business, side gig, something like that, just pay attention to what you're getting and write it down, Gemini. And it might not come all at one time. You might be getting bits and pieces of it. So you're going to have to keep a running list. What is the advice card? Mother Mary. Love yourself, others, in every situation, no matter what the outward appearance will be. I feel like this has to do with lifting your vibration again. So going back to this base chakra card, make sure you're doing what you love in order to lift the vibration up. I also feel like there's an affirmation for you. It's also about loving the situations and circumstances and conditions, even though they don't feel 100% right now. And even though if you don't feel 100% okay and right with where you're at in your financial life, there is a affirmation that goes something like, everything is in divine and perfect order right now. And when you say that as often as you can, especially in the morning, your higher self, which is the magic part of you, hears that and it triumphs over the negative part of you that's saying that you don't have enough money or that there's something wrong with your money, right? So I feel like there's going to have to be a reach to fix if there's a problem here, okay? Your third house rules your brother or sister. Okay, so they've been going in a certain direction, and it's time for them to, number one, face the facts. They can't sweep the dirty laundry under the rug anymore and ignore it. It's time for them to make the changes that are required, that are being required to make in their lives right now. Annie is here to say, take a leap of faith, that they will definitely have to take a calculated risk in order to overcome the circumstance. For some of them, it's going to be leaving a relationship, certainly, or it's going to be leaving a job, or it's going to be going to a new line of work or a new moving. It could be anything. It's going to be different for each one of you, Geminis, with your brother or sister. Your fourth house, house of home, where you currently live, you have sacrifice. Sacrifice suggests that you're doing a lot of work in or around your home, or there's something about your home that feels like hard work. You're not getting enough return in order for you to feel valuable. You know, the Gemini likes to go out and likes to party anyway, so you may be finding yourself having less time at home because it just doesn't feel right. Ishtar is here to say boundaries. Okay, so this could also be talking about a roommate or someone that you lived with, a loved one, a child, who is not doing their part here, Gemini. So it's time for you to draw a line in the sand and say, you know what? I've been cleaning up after you for 15 or 18 or 22 years, and I would like some help in the house duties, house chores, household situation. You can at least clean up after yourself after you make yourself some food. Can you tell that I have a teenager? It's just so easy for me to say those things. Fifth house. Fifth house rules your dating life. For those of you that are single, Geminis. For those of you that are happily coupled, this is talking about your social circle, your networking. Wow. Ace of Cups. Single Geminis could definitely meet someone in the month of December if you're looking. Ace of Cups is the, or pardon me, Love Begins is the Ace of Cups in traditional tarot, which means big love. Now, for those of you that are coupled, I would definitely say yes to the social invitations that you get right now, because you're going to be meeting people who you will love. And it doesn't, you know, it can be a platonic love. It can be new friendships. It can be new groups of people. It could be networking with cool people that you never even thought possible. Una is here to say easy does it, though. So for those of you who are dating and you meet someone, I wouldn't jump in 100% head first. This other person, although it looks promising, may have some cold feet about stage 5 Klingons, if you catch my drift. So I would definitely take it easy, take it slow. There's no need to rush. That's what the Una card means. And don't try to force it to happen, because this card says everything is happening in perfect and divine timing. Sixth house, work and health, emotional withdrawal. The Gemini may need to take a long weekend near a body of water to regroup and recharge. You've got Maeve, which talks about cycles and rhythms. Now, if you are female, and if you are experiencing a unusual female cycle, then this message is for you, right? Because the body has been thrown off of its usual path. It doesn't necessarily mean that there's anything wrong. Of course, always seek medical attention if you're having symptoms. But sometimes these changes and shifts just occur naturally, right? And so, you know, you might be in a new body cycle with all of that female reproductive stuff going on. Okay. Seventh house rules primary relationships. You have the teacher. The teacher is present. For each Gemini, this is going to be different. This could mean that your partner is currently teaching you something. This could mean that you are currently teaching your partner something. This could be that you're both learning something from each other. This could also mean that some Geminis are in the process or in the midst of some marriage counseling or couples counseling or therapy, and you're learning new things in that direction. This could be that a person is teaching your spouse or your partner new things, okay? Either way, this is a good thing. You need to learn these lessons, and so does this partner for those of you that are partnered. Arasura is here to talk about blossoming. You are just getting started, this card says. Have patience with yourself and the process, and do not give up. Do not give up. Keep going and learn these lessons. Now we have a warning. Here we go with the warning parts of the reading. Eighth house rules intimacy, taxes, contracts, legal matters, and the source of your significant other's income, if you have that. The disruption card is the falling tower card. There is something here where it feels like the rug is being pulled out from underneath you. For some of you coupled, this is going to mean that your significant other is not able to bring in the funds to the relationship that they once did. For others of you, this is going to mean that a lawsuit did not go in your favor, or it's not going in your favor at this time, or the tax issue that might be hanging over the head, or the contract issue did not come to fruition, or something fell through, or something like that. However, not to worry, because you pulled Matt, which talks about fairness. The bottom of this card says the situation will be handled in a fair and just manner. Now, what I've learned with Matt over the years, and this is true in my own personal life when I pulled her before, the presence of Matt means, yes, this will be resolved. However, it might not be resolved in December. In December, you might be feeling this still. But I'm telling you that feeling this does not mean that you will still be in this place in the months to come ahead of December. So at some point, this will be resolved. She actually has the scales of justice on this card. I can't make this up. This, the eighth house rules legal things. Okay, so try not to worry about that one too much, Gemini. Ninth house rules your travel, rules your school. For those of you that are considering or going to school, taking a class, or learning something new, or maybe you're already in school. Deception and envy. Someone is trying to pull the wool over your eyes, Gemini. This could be someone that's trying to talk you into taking a trip with them. And so, if that's the case, I would definitely say no to this person. The other thing that's possible is if you already have a trip booked, you could meet someone at this destination who's not telling you the truth. Problem. That's a problem. Warning, warning, right? What is the advice card? Green Tara, start delegating. Okay, so if someone's trying to get you to do something that you don't want to do on this trip, at the destination, then you need to start looking for other people who can do it for this other person, making suggestions. At the end of the day, it shouldn't be the Gemini. The Gemini should say no. Geminis have no problem saying no, am I right? You'd love to say no more often than you would say yes. Unless it's a huge party that you really want to attend and exciting. 10th house rules the career. Also, for those of you that's not talking about career, could be talking about your mother. Choose wisely. So this says that you could have multiple options when it comes to career or job, or perhaps your mother could have multiple options that she's facing in her life right now. However, the energy is Gemini energy in this case, in that it's feeling too scattered to make a solid decision here. Aphrodite is here to talk about shaking up your energy, awaken the goddess within you through dance, self-care, and appreciating your divinity in the inner goddess. That is interesting. And it also suggests and really echoes this message of not making a decision here, but instead making yourself feel good. And in that good feeling place, you will be in a better set of frame of mind to make a decision. And same is true for your mother. What do we have with the child department here in the 11th house for those of you Geminis that have children? For those of you that don't have children, this is talking about your best friend. Stand your ground. Okay, so some children need to stand firmly in their beliefs and stand up for what they believe. But for others of you, this is talking about making a stand physically with your child and telling them no and putting your foot down and saying, no, you know, that's not a good idea. You're not going to do that. Maybe you've talked me into, you know, saying yes after I've said no, but not today and not about this situation. What do we have here? Butterfly transformation. Okay, so this is you or your child is laying the groundwork for a corner that they're going to turn. Perhaps they have been too meek or shy or timid to stand up for themselves in the past, and they are finally shook up enough to make a stand and not go back here. And that action of standing your ground and staying there actually changes the future and how they handle these adverse events. Same is true for you, Gemini, if you're dealing with a child in the midst of some sort of power struggle. It happens. It happens. No judgment. We all do it. Your 12th house, what's about to happen and manifest in the future approximately 3 months from now? You have spiritual strength. Spiritual strength is the second challenge card in this deck. You are feeling more challenged than usual around the month of March 2020. What is the advice card that we have? Dana, High Priestess. Unlike ordinary challenges, Gemini, you are going to be handling this in a very unusual manner. you are going to be calling on the wisdom that you have received, get this, in previous lifetimes in order to help you resolve the challenges that come up and face you in March. Some of you, excuse me, I need a drink. Some of you have never faced this type of challenge before, but let's face it. I think we're all pretty much in that boat as we live in these days, if you know what I mean, these challenging times. So this will be a learning experience for you that you can overcome more, much more than what you thought you were capable or able of doing. All right? So keep that faith, Gemini. Many blessings. Thank you so much for being here with me, and happy holidays to you, whatever you celebrate.